A very happy morning to one and all. Myself Triveni, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry at Raghavendra Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research. On behalf of Raipur family, I heartily welcome all the dignitaries, delegates and students for these two AICTE sponsored 6 days short-term training programs. One STTP is being organized by Department of Pharmaceutical Analysis and Quality Assurance with the theme of Green Chemistry and Advanced Analytical Techniques of Pharmaceuticals and Product Development Aspects as per the regulatory requirements. And another STTP program being organized by Department of Pharmacy Practice with the theme of Clinical Mapping of Epidemiology and Biostatistics in Biomedical and Health Research. These AICTE professional training programs produce promising outcomes in the learning and teaching practices in the field of technical education. Through these STTPs, faculty develop skills and leadership qualities to impart knowledge in the students. Without further delay, I request all the dignitaries onto the dais. First and foremost, I invite Dr. Y. Padmanabha Reddy Garu, Honorable Principal of Raipur, onto the dais and receive our resemblance of gratitude. Now I invite Dr. P. Ramalingam Garu, R&D Director, Raipur, and receive our resemblance of gratitude. Now I invite STTP Program Coordinator, Head Department of Pharmaceutical Analysis, Dr. Vinod Kumar Garu, onto the dais and receive our resemblance of gratitude. Now I invite another STTP Program Coordinator, Head Department of Pharmacy Practice, Dr. B. Pradeep Kumar Garu, onto the dais and receive our resemblance of gratitude. It's my privilege to invite today's guest of honor, Dr. Murugan Panchaksharam, Head Operation, Vice President, Ameris Clinical, onto the dais and receive our resemblance of gratitude. It's my honor to invite today's chief guest onto the dais, Dr. B. Praveen Kumar, MS Orthopedics, RDT Hospital, onto the dais and receive our resemblance of gratitude. Thank you, sir. It is our tradition to begin our program with lightening of lamp. Now I invite all the respected dignitaries on the dais to come and join for the lighting of lamp. Thank you, sir. Now I invite Miss Manasa, 4th Form D, for the prayer song.
Gananayakaya, Ganadaivataya, Ganadhyakshaya, Dhimahi गुण शरीराय गुण मंडिताय गुणेशानाय धीमहि गुणातीताय गुणादेशाय गुण प्रवेष्टाय धीमहि एकदंताय वक्रतुंडाय गौरीतनय धीमहि गजेशानाय बालचंद्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि एकदंताय वक्रतुंडाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय बालचंद्राय श्री गणेशाय धीमहि.
थैंक यू मानसम. Now I invite Dr. Y. Padmanabha Reddy Garu, Principal of RIPER, to address the gathering.
Very good morning to all of you. Respected dignitaries on the dais, my colleagues, Dr. Ramalingam, Director, R&D, RIPER, HODs and Program Coordinators, Dr. Vinod Kumar, Head of the Department for Pharmaceutical Analysis, who is also the coordinator on behalf of this STDP program of 6 days training program of pharmacy analysis and quality assurance. Another good friend, colleague, Dr. Pradeep, head department of pharmacy practice and also the coordinator for this another 6 day AICT sponsored STDP short term training program. And today's guest with us, Dr. Murugan Panchakhara from Amaris Clinical, a unit of Kaplan, and also the director of RDT Hospitals, Pattalapalli, Dr. Praveen Kumar Garu, and my colleagues sitting before me, dear delegates, who have come over here for this 2 short-term training programs of 6 days from 8th to 13th. And my dear students, very good morning to all of you once again, and warm greetings from Raghavendra Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research. For the sake of our guests and also the delegates from other colleges, I would like to say a few words about RIPER. This RIPER, Raghavendra Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, was established in the year 2002 under Raghavendra Educational and Rural Development Society by a group of pharmacy professionals. It was started with a B.Pharm with 60 intake. Then diploma was introduced in the year 2003. In the year 2008, pharmacy post-graduation programs have been added, pharmaceutical analysis and quality assurance. At that time it was a branch together, that is there are no separate branches, only the pharmaceutical analysis, including the pharmaceutical analysis and quality assurance, with an intake of 8. And then the same year we had the opportunity of getting approval for starting PharmD program, which was introduced in the same year 2008 throughout India with a kind support and MOU from RDT hospitals. Later on departments have been added, and in the year 2004 Institute was accredited by National Board of Accreditation. That Bachelor of Pharmacy program was accredited by NBA, and then followed by 2016 it was accredited by NAC, and the same year we got the autonomy granted by University Grants Commission. Since the inception of the NIRF ranking, National Institute Ranking Framework, our institute, I am happy to share the information that our institute is consistently being listed at all India level. Last year we got 55th rank, and I am sure that This year also, we are going to get a better rank than 55. A better rank means less than 55. I am sure and hopeful because of the wonderful contribution and by our faculty, headed by Director R&D, particularly. Why? Because I am telling you, during COVID period, I am happy to share that our faculty have come out with 50 plus publications in SCI Index journals, which is going to be a major distinct point for consideration of NIRF ranking also. At the same time, we are also happy to share, I am happy to share you that every year we are getting grants from different agencies. This year also, we got 5 projects from AICTE, out of which 3 are STDP programs and another 2 projects are there. One is the research promotion scheme and the another one is the for training and development for particularly SC and ST students. So these are going to help us. So, and as a part of it, because AICTE has, even though AICTE has not come forward for with grants for arranging such programs, our institute, particularly the various departments under our institute headed by R&D, is constantly and continuously arranging various training sessions and enrichment programs, particularly on various techniques, because we had very good facilities, laboratory facilities, particularly the special equipments also we had, and some space also we had, and various of all these, and all these equipments or the softwares, our faculty are arranging various training programs, and this STDP is going, these 2 STDPs are going to help the delegates a lot, because every day there is, it was arranged in such a way, in the morning there will be a lecture by the resource persons and in the afternoon there will be a hands-on training session. We have planned like that, and I request the delegates who have come from different institutes throughout AP, Tamil Nadu, or Karnataka, or Telangana to utilize this opportunity and get benefit out of it, so that it will be useful for your professional career, and also it will be useful when you go back to your institute and teach the students. So I once again thank on behalf of RIPAR the 2 important guests of today to RIPAR, Dr. Praveen Garu and Dr. Murugan Garu, to come all the way to attend this inaugural session. And I also congratulate the 2 coordinators who have submitted the proposals to AICTE and successfully got the grants for arranging this 6-day short-term training program. And I wish all of you that you are going to benefit a lot out of it, and you are going to have a happy stay at RIPAR. And I also request the delegates, if any one of you are going to face any problems, please bring to the notice of our faculty, the team, volunteer team. They will take care and try to resolve the issues immediately. So thank you for giving me this opportunity, and wish that these 2 short-term training programs a grand success. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite Dr. P. Ramalingam Garu, Director, R&D Department, to address the gathering.
Good morning, one and all. At the outset, it's my pleasure to be here on the stage with the 2 eminent personalities of this inaugural session. Number one, Dr. Praveen, Director, RDT Hospital, Battalapalli. Number two, my friend and my senior, and currently working as Head Operation and Vice President of Amaris Clinical Trials, Captain Point, Chennai, who is all the way comes from Chennai to here by his own driving and to address the gallery. And we are meeting, of course, after 17 years. And my beloved principal and coordinators of the STDP, Dr. Praveen and Dr. Sapetar and Dr. Vinod Kumar. And I'm here as a part of R&D to say something about what we have done in the R&D for the past. As an academic institution of this Raipur, it's established in 2002. It's a very old institution as academic institutions. But in the purview of research institution, when compared to all other institutions existing in Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, we are the youngest research institution in the state. In academically we are old, but research we are youngest. But still we have satisfied that we reached the milestone, the satisfactory milestone in attracting grants from various agencies or executing the research in the campus in the different sector or developing the research facility in different departments. To say in the one word, our first research grant was sanctioned in the year 2012 to Dr. Y. Padmanabh Reddy sir, it's on tuberculosis. It was our first achievement in 2012. From 2012 to till today, and I can proudly say that the total amount of 2.3 crores we have received from the different agencies. That include from AICT, DST, from DBT, and PC also. Out of which, most of the research grants are from funded research, and the current ongoing research, we are much focused on tuberculosis and neuropharmacology and cancer, especially formulation department, nanoformulations. These are more core areas what is going on the right part. And apart from that, with the help of the placement officer, Dr. Somasagar Reddy, I don't think so, he is not here. And we are also trying to develop various collaboration with the industry also for the benefit of the PG graduates. And you know that for the knowledge of the guests, I just wanted to open that. In entire Andhra Pradesh, after the inception of this scheme, the fee reimbursement, the government of Andhra Pradesh, the PG education is much polluted. Almost 95% of the colleges in Andhra Pradesh, they started practicing part-time. But in the context, I feel proud, I feel happy, proud to work at the IPA that our management team, our management members like Dr. Padmanabh Reddy or Ravindra Reddy sir, they are totally against that part-time. So even though 3-4 years ago we had a lot of tough time that we don't get admission for the PG students as we are running a full-time, and we are not compromised, and we have continued the full-time, we don't entertain even a single candidate for part-time. So as a result, and this year we feel a little happy that and the attractions towards the PG admission to Raipur and the application approach are keep on increasing, so where it means the quality matters. So with this context, I may request, it may be my request personally to Mr. Murugan, or it may be a request from college side under the principal to him, because I know that Captain Point, they are accommodating the student even with the stipend for the needy for second year in FR&D, AR&D, even for pharmacy practice as well as pharmacology. So even they have MOU with some other university also. So I may request to Mr. Murugan and on behalf of college and to come up with the MOU to our institutions so that and the needy candidate may be posted in the second year. And it's not something like a placement, it's a training. During the training program, if you feel satisfied and our scholars, you may accommodate him, are mutually interested, they can continue the job at Captain Point.
So as we, because we made the request, as I know that Captain Point is the leading clinical trial organization in India. It's making so many US FDA projects, they're executing, and they have a lot of link up with the other MNC also. So with this brief note, I wish the coordinator Dr. Pradeep and Dr. Vinod Kumar to make this short-term training program as a grand success. And I wish all the participants and to get benefit out of that, as principals have said, if you have any deficit, you please report us immediately and so that it will be resolved. And I wish you all the best and thank you, Anandal. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to invite STTP program coordinator, head Department of Pharmaceutical Analysis, Dr. K. Vinod Kumar Garu, to address the gathering.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma Tasmay Sri Gurave Namo. So why I'm starting with this saying, because this training program is for gurus, teachers. So at the outset, respected principal sir and director, three directors are there on the stage. One is RDD director sir, Praveen sir, and another director sir, R&D director sir, and another vice president, Captain Point, Mr. Murugan sir, and my colleague Pradeep sir. And I would like to thank first STTP for giving this opportunity to conduct a program, and also I would like to thank all the delegates who came all the way from Hyderabad and other corners of Andhra Pradesh. And as a coordinator, I would like to say one thing only, that you have given freedom. So we have given one agenda for you. So that is not compulsory to follow. And suppose if one faculty come or few faculty come with some topic, sir, we want training on this topic, we can modify that. So I'm giving that freedom to all the delegates so that we can modify the topic according to our interest. Okay, so I wish all the best to you. And if you feel any discomfort at any place, please contact me or our delegates. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to invite another STTP program coordinator, head Department of Pharmacy Practice, Dr. Pradeep Kumar Garu, to address the gathering.
Dignitaries on the dais, Principal Riper, Chief Patron of this AICT sponsored STTP, Dr. Y. Patna Reddy Garu. Today's chief guest, Director, RDT Hospital, Battalapalli, Dr. Praveen Kumar Garu. Guest of honor and the eminent speaker of today's program, Dr. Murugan Garu. Director, R&D Cell, Riper, Dr. P. Ramalingam Garu. My colleague and coordinator of another STTP, Dr. Vinod Kumar Garu. Delegates of this AICT sponsored STTP from various colleges. My colleagues of the dais, non-teaching staff, volunteers, very good morning, one and all. I thank principals of various colleges, that is Vijaya College of Pharmacy, Vijayawada, Chaprol Hanumaya Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Gunturu, CMR College of Pharmacy, Hyderabad, Government Arts College, Anantapur, Balaji College of Pharmacy, Anantapur, OTEPRI, Anantapur, SKU, Anantapur, for sending faculty to attend this program. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to the AICT sponsored STTP on clinical mapping of epidemiology and biostatistics in biomedical and health research. So in this occasion, I want to say a few words about this STTP. This STTP is designed to provide statistical support in research designs and analysis. During this program, participants will have exposure to various statistical software tools like SPSS and EpiInfo. So after completion of this program, all participants will be able to know concepts of epidemiology, how to select a study design, different statistical tools, protocol writing, ethics in scientific writing, reference managers like Jotaro, signal detection in pharmacovigilance using FAERS database. And I want to say thanks to AICT for granting fund to organize this program. And I am very fortunate to have the support from great leader of this college, our beloved principal, Dr. YPR, for his continuous support, and as well as Director of R&D, Dr. P. Ramalingam Garu. And finally, I sincerely hope you will enjoy today's and next 6 days of this program. Thank you for your participation.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite today's guest of honor, Mr. Murugan Panchaksharam, Head Operation Vice President, to address the gathering.
Good morning, all. So, thank you for the wonderful opportunity given by the all. I'd like to thank him. Also I'd like to thank Dr. Ramalingam for inviting me for this presentation. And actually, I am working as a vice president in Kaplan Point in the CRO division. So we do phase trials and bioequivalent studies at our center. So today I'm going to give a topic after this session, probably like the challenges in the clinical trials. One thing is amazing here. This morning I went to the facility too. This facility is amazing. I've been visited many pharmacy colleges, but this pharmacy college is very special to me because each divisions they're performing well. Like especially they have. I think students are working here. In many pharmacy colleges, they won't allow even the HPLC. Even when we studied our colleges, they won't allow to operate HPLC and all. It's kind of a showcase. They just see from outside only. But here, morning and when we visited, I've seen one student is working in HPLC. So it's a great thing. I can see a lot of changes here. And also many things. The principal is like, basically he is a pharmacy background. He has given the lot of opportunity. One more thing I'm proud to say, recently I have taken one candidate from Raipur. That is a proverb in Tamil, they say, Urupana Sodhukku Urusuru Padam. His name is Srikanth. He joined recently in our team. He's extraordinarily is working. He come to office by 7:30 and leave by 7:30. The difference is makes like, I'm not seen. Nowadays people in a different world, they think like, 5 days in a week and weekend parties. The culture is changed in those days, but especially it's not like that. So work and family culture both has to be balanced, and especially knowledge is most important thing actually. So also yesterday I discussed with Mr. Ramalingam regarding the part-time. This college is not entertaining any part-time pharmacy thing. When we interview candidates, so there is some kind of some mismatch will be there in the CV. Recently I came up with this, and we have taken one quality assurance head for our organization. What happened, the CV, he is one of working in the international company. There the experience is in 2006 to 2008, it shows there in the organization. Also, he has done a PG. Almost we are about to release the offer letter for 30 lakhs package. There is a conflict when we do for background verification. This guy has done some part-time PGs, some colleges. So ethically it is not allowed. See, he is going to head the quality assurance team. So quality assurance is ensuring the quality of the thing. The person mind is like that, we can do this kind, definitely quality won't be there. So we stop the offer letter. Because this part-time and this not matching. So he felt very proud that people are thinking that it's a very small thing, but it's not like that. See, if you go abroad, if you go, there'll be every pharma companies, especially corporate companies, they do background verification. Okay, if they come across with these kind of thing, no companies will accept, especially corporate companies. They won't entertain the conflict like that, working in their studying. There is no colleges, pharmacies allowing a part-time thing. See, we have to obey the rules. So, I sincerely request, especially RIPER, they are not allowing, really will appreciate. So, the quality is very good, and I proudly say that guy, so definitely whatever he said, we can accommodate in analytical two guys, quality assurance department two, and clinical part, Mr. Stephen, we can accommodate in our team, not an issue. Once again, I thank you, principal, and given me an opportunity for this. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. It is my honor to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. P. Praveen Kumar Garu, MS Orthopedics, RDT, Patalpally Hospital. Now, I request Dr. B. Sahithi to introduce today's chief guest.
Good morning to all the respected dignitaries on the dais and the delegates. I feel it as my privilege to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. B. Praveen Kumar Sir, MS, Ortho, Director, RDT Hospital, Battalpally. Sir has received his MBBS degree from NTR University of Health Sciences and completed his MS Orthopedics from SV Degree College, SV Medical College, NTR University of Health Sciences. After completion of his education, Sir has dedicated his services to Department of Orthopedics, RDT Hospital, Battalpally. During his post-graduation, Sir had the opportunity to work with Dr. Rajshekaran, Director, Ganga Hospital for 1 month. And Sir has attended two fellowships. And during the fellowship, Sir had undergone under various training under the mentorship of various national and international physicians. Sir has given presentations during ASAPCON and SICOT World Congress organized by International Society of Orthopedic Surgery and Traumatology. And during our journey with RDT Hospital, Sir has given us a lot of support and care to our institution and to our students. With this brief introduction, I'd like to invite Dr. Praveen Sir to address the gathering.
Thanks for the kind introduction. Dignitaries on the dais, faculty of RIPER, students and delegates, a very pleasant good morning to one and all. It's my honor to be here as a chief guest on this inaugural session. I feel that this is one of the best institutes regarding pharmacy education and training. I've been interacting with their students, I think, since almost 5-6 years, and they have produced one of the best students. I've gone through there. I've worked as a co-guide for some of their research papers. They are of very high quality. I think at this outset, I must really appreciate Dr. Padmanabh Reddy Garu, you know, for taking so much time and effort and pain to establish such a big institute. And he firmly stood for what he believed. You know, this is something which we must all appreciate him, you know, for 18 years. It's a long span of time. For 18 years to run an institute with good quality education, you know, imparting principles, imparting discipline. This is something which is, I think, an extraordinary thing. Of course, education can be, good education will be provided in institutes, but imparting discipline and imparting, you know, is not a simple thing. And I must also appreciate their students. Some of them have provided, rendered extraordinary services during COVID times. This is something I must, you know, really appreciate them. They have come forward when we are at a tough time. when we used to run hospital with 400 beds for exclusive COVID patients, we are in short of many staff, not only doctors, nurses. They have worked as physician assistants, clinical pharmacists. They helped us. So this is something which we cherish, and they have come forward. At the time, there was a lot of fear, you know, even among the senior doctors to, you know, provide services to the COVID patients. But students from this institute have come forward and provided good service. I can say not only good service, an extraordinary service to the needy patients. And once again, I thank Principal Dr. Padma Bhatti Garu for giving this wonderful opportunity to be in this inaugural session. And I request all the delegates, you know, to take, you know, to make use of this wonderful opportunity for 6 days. And thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation and sharing your experience with our institution.
So it's sorry for the interruption. So a kind of thanking note. So as directed by the principal, so as the captain point accepted our request for MOU, and we thank on behalf of institutions and all the PG department, and we'll start initiating the draft of MOU by tomorrow, so that we can go for at least two from each department, including pharmacy practice, pharmacy, and other QA and analysis and obstetrics. And we thank you for your presence and for all the way you come. And one more thing, very key point I just forgot, and as we said, that we are continuously growing towards development of research, and with the support of principal, this fund is purely by the college, and we established zebrafish facility, because as you know, the preclinical trials usually we do it on rodent model, and as of the trend is growing up, and we started setting up the preclinical testing on zebrafish also. So we are testing drug model in zebrafish. And initially we planned for cancer and tuberculosis. Cancer is almost in the stuck stage because there are some technical issues going on. But the TB model is going on in the support of ICMR NIRT. So we have a project in collaboration with ICMR NIRT. So for those molecules, we are testing that molecule and zebrafish that we have set up, number one. And number two, with the college fund, we don't have any fund for cell culture facility cancer screening. With the college fund, we have already placed order for all equipment, and facility setup is under progress. And I request all the faculty members, if you feel, if you want any support from us regarding cancer facility as well as zebrafish, and you may approach us, and we are ready to provide your support with the minimum cost, with only the cost, only minimum the cost. That is the one announcement we wanted to do it at. So these two facilities are new at Raipur in 2021, zebrafish and cell culture. Thank you very much.
So I would like to add one more point on this particular day, because when I was interacting with Dr. Murugan in the morning, really he was appreciating our students, particularly the alumni who have left our institute and joined various pharma companies, because he had a lot of contacts at high level who are working with different companies. For example, he was telling that Biocon is totally satisfied with the alumni of Raipur. Whatever, whoever from Raipur is going to approach, they are ready to take. And in the same way, this capping point also, he also got impressed very much with the performance of our students. And really, I am proud with my alumni, particularly who have been trying, the proud faculty of our institute. And on this occasion, I would like to, on behalf of Raipur family, I would like to thank Dr. Praveen sir also, who had given a wonderful opportunity to our students, particularly, I can't say two students, it is almost passed out students, to work with them as duty doctors during COVID period also, and particularly, they have given them regular appointments. Now they are working with RDT as maybe the duty doctors, I can't say exactly the word which they have used, because they have been given permanent appointment with RDT, and I feel that 12 students, have, as far as my knowledge is concerned, 12 Formby students have been given appointment with RDT. And I thank you, sir, for your gesture and also to RDT on behalf of Riper family. And at the same time, I would like to express my sincere thanks on behalf of Riper and also the entire family to Dr. Murugan also, who has come forward to have MOU with Riper for giving training or maybe the project work during the second year of PG program for pharmacy practice, as well as pharmaceutical quality assurance, pharmaceutical analysis, and pharmaceutics. These four departments he has assured, and I am sure that our students will definitely work very hard, and also they will meet your expectations. Thank you, sir, for giving the opportunity to our students. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It's time to felicitate our guest. I request all the dignitaries on the dais to felicitate today's guest of honor, Mr. Murugan Panchaksharam. On the dais to felicitate today's chief guest, Dr. P. Praveen Kumar Garu.